हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे विल स्टार्ट विथ द टॉपिक द एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम। इन दिस पोर्शन विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द वेरियस एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स, देयर करस्पॉन्डिंग हार्मोन्स। विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द हार्मोनल इन्फ्लुएंसेस, द एक्शन ऑफ हार्मोनल डिसऑर्डर्स लाइक गॉइटर, क्रेटिनिज्म, एक्सोथर्मिक गॉइटर, डायबिटिक मिलिटस, डायबिटिक इंसिपिडस, ड्वार्फिज्म, जेजेंडिज्म एंड एक्रोमेगैली, एंड ऑल्सो रोल ऑफ हार्मोन्स इन रिप्रोडक्टिव साइकिल। सो एज वी मूव ऑन विद द एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम, वी शुड बी वेरी थरो दैट इन आर बॉडी देर आर टू सिस्टम्स विच कंट्रोल द होल फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द बॉडी। दे फंक्शन टुगेदर, एक्ट टुगेदर, कोऑर्डिनेट्स together to carry out all the activities of the body. Those are the nervous system and the endocrine system. As we know that nervous system simply speaks about the impulses, nerve impulses. It speaks about the neurotransmitter, chemical transmitters, and there the information is passed through the impulses and through chemical signals that we call it as neurotransmitters. And the characteristics of a nervous system is that the information is passed very fast, that is response is very fast, and the effect will be of short duration, and it acts as a specific target. So three factors, that is the response is very fast, but the effect is for a short duration, and the impact is on a particular specific target. But when I speak about endocrine system, I could say that the information is passed through some chemical transmitters, we call it as hormone, and it regulates, it is released from one part of the body and it have its function in some other part of the body, or it controls the activity of some other part of the body. But when I compare it with nervous system, its response is very slow. It takes some time to have its influence, but then the effect lasts for a long time, long duration, and the influence is for a broader sense, that is it's not for a single cell or it's not a specific one. It have its function, the most of its function is the target, it is having a broader influences. Now when we come in detail with the endocrine system, we can see that what is an endocrine system. It is nothing but an integrated system of some small organs, and that happens to release some signaling molecules, some chemicals, and we call those chemicals as hormones. And these, we can see that these cells which happens to secrete the hormone, I can call them as endocrine cells. And you may be familiar with exocrine and endocrine. I'll just differentiate it. Endocrine means those cells which happens to secrete a chemical signaling molecule, and it is simply released directly into the blood. There is no blood vessels, or no, we could say no duct, no tubes to carry these signaling molecule from the gland. That means a gland means a structure, organ, organ which can release something, which have some secretion, we call it as a gland. And when it happens to release directly into the blood and does not have any duct, any tube, any vessel to carry that chemical from that gland to the target, we call it as the endocrine gland. But on the other hand, exocrine means the gland will be connected with a duct, a tube, and it connects to the target. So the chemical will be moving through that tube till it reaches the target, and in that case I call it as exocrine gland. So here when I speak about hormones and the related glands, we normally are concerned with the endocrine system. That means those hormones are released directly into the blood, and it is not being carried through any duct. That's why we can call these gland as ductless glands. Okay, so here we can see, so the cells or the cells that would secrete the hormone, I can call them very well as endocrine cell, and the gland or the organ, I can call them as endocrine gland. And the organs which get influenced, or the target, we call it as target organ. So So hormones are normally, as I said, it is carried through the body fluids. And what is its function? They bring about a great influence on the physiological functions like metabolism, growth, reproduction, osmoregulation, circulation, etc. Now, as I have already briefed about, there are two types of glands, exocrine, which are ducted, and endocrine, which are ductless glands. And these endocrine, they release the product, the hormones directly into the blood fluid, directly into the interstitial fluid or into the blood. Now, we'll just speak about the endocrine glands, the examples. Endocrine glands include like pituitary, thyroid, parathyroid, adrenal, pineal glands, which are directly, we can see the exclusive function, the primary function is endocrine for them. In next, we are discussing about some other organs which do have endocrine function, but then their primary function will be something else, like for example, hypothalamus, thymus, pancreas, ovaries, testes, kidney, stomach, liver, small intestine, skin, heart, adipose tissue, placenta. So here we could see that though these organs do have endocrine function, but their primary function is something else, or I could say their exclusive function is not endocrine. That is, they may be, like for example, we know pancreas, if we take, it is having some other function to digestion, right? Testes, ovaries, they have their own reproductive function, but then yes, they do have some secretion, that is, they secrete hormones. So we can say that even though they are not exclusively having the function of endocrine, they do have some secretion for sure. Okay, next we'll come back with what are hormones. Hormones are extracellular signaling molecule, and these are released by the endocrine glands. So these are some signaling, and these are chemicals, right? And these are very small. So we'll discuss about some characteristics feature of these hormones. These are very small molecules. And when I speak about its chemical nature, it can be a peptide, it can be a steroid, or it can be, in fact, amines. And these are released, as we know, released by some gland, of course, specifically by endocrine glands. And these are directly released into the interstitial fluid from where it diffuses into the blood. So it is transported through blood plasma, and they reach the target. And we can see that these chemicals are released in a very small, very tiny quantity, and that is sufficient enough to bring about the large influence on the very important or vital metabolic activity. Mostly they are fast released, and for example, in the case of normally we said it is having a small response, but then in some cases there are some exceptions like adrenaline, where it is fastly been released, and it remains in the system for a very short time. That even though influence is for a long time, this chemical remain in the system for a very short time, for 1 to 2 minutes, and high specificity they are having with the specific receptors. They bring about the function on the specific organ or the system. So here we could see the systems, like here we could see the picture, hypothalamus, starting from the top, hypothalamus, pituitary, pineal gland, thyroid, thymus, heart, stomach, kidney, uterus, ovary in the females, and testes in the males, adrenal glands, pancreas, small intestine, like the skin, these, and on the back side we are having the parathyroid gland, thyroid glands. All these are included under endocrine system. Now, on the basis of chemical, we can classify hormones into two, that is lipid soluble and water soluble. When I speak about lipid soluble, these cannot be simply being transmuted through the blood plasma, because we know that the major constituent of plasma is water. And here the hormone, you could just think this is a lipid soluble chemical. So this cannot completely be soluble in the water of the plasma. So what happen is that to be transported, of course, it have to be transported by the blood. So the blood uses some carrier proteins to carry these lipids from the glands to its target. The best example are the adrenal hormones, the hormones of reproductive glands like the testosterone, estrogen, steroid hormones, of course, are being included under this. So steroid hormones are one of the best example, and they most of them will be having chemically a structure of a cholesterol molecule with four rings, and or these may be the hormone, either they may be having a cholesterol ring structure, or they, or in the second case, these may be the hormones which are being produced from the cholesterol. Precursors may be cholesterol. Okay, so it can be either completely a cholesterol hormone, or these may be synthesized from a cholesterol molecule. Next is water soluble. They circulate free in the water because, yes, plasma, of course, the major constituent is water. And the best examples are amine hormones, peptide hormones. So amine hormones are the hormones which include nitrogen containing derivatives of the amino acids like tyrosine or tryptophan. The best example is a thyroid hormone, or the hormones which are released from the adrenal medulla, nephrine, epinephrine, that is adrenaline, noradrenaline, or those hormones of pineal gland. When I speak about the second category, water soluble hormone, that is peptide hormones, this have a few amino acids to several hundreds of amino acids. Molecular weight may be 20 to 30,000. The best example is insulin, glucagon, parathormone, vasopressin, oxytocin. Another one is glycoprotein hormones. These may be polypeptide. They are longer than 100 amino acids, and they may be having carbohydrates too. The best example is follicular stimulating hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, human chorionic gonadotropin, luteinizing hormone, etc. So for time being, we'll stop. Thank you.